today I'm going to show you 10 things you can do instead of throwing out your computer. Now, normally when you're doing a new system build or buying a new computer, it's customary just to get rid of the old computer, smash the hard drive, whatever the case may be. Some state laws require you to dispose of it properly. This may cost you a little money. Some places give you rebates or coupons, depending on the rules. Number one, give to people in need. Okay, so giving to people in need. It's very easy to format a machine or delete your user profile off the computer. You can then give it to a friend, family member, or even a child. Just load a bunch of free games. There are so many free games out there on Steam, and there's a lot of free DOS games. I'm sure they would enjoy it as a gaming machine. Number two, format and upgrade. Formatting and upgrading. It's not very difficult to upgrade an old machine and keeping it as a backup. For instance, a laptop, you could add more RAM, and even a desktop. It's very easy to pop them open, see what kind of RAM they take, and max it out. It usually only costs about $20 or $30, especially on an old machine, so the parts are cheap. Number three, make a Boinc server. You can run it as a Boinc server. Boinc is a wonderful cloud computing platform where you can donate your computing power to research projects for diseases, mathematical calculations, and other great projects. Number four, create a media server for your TV. If your video card has an HDMI out, you can actually hook it up to a TV and use it as a media server for things like Hulu, Netflix, and YouTube. And the nice thing about that is you can usually pick up a card with an HDMI out for about $30. Depending on the card, it may not do 1080, but it can most certainly do 720. Many people that also do this buy a wireless keyboard and mouse so they can be on the couch and control the TV. Number five, harvest for usable parts. Harvesting for usable parts. Now, this is something that I do whenever I'm doing a new system build. If the parts for my old machine are somewhat compatible with my new build, I may hold off on buying a particular part. For instance, if I do not have the money at that point in time to buy the motherboard, CPU, RAM, and a video card, I may pull my current video card out of the machine and use it in my next build. And the same thing goes for the RAM. DDR3 and DDR4 are the most common RAM at this point in time. My current machine does have DDR3, so if one of my older machines has DDR3, I'll check the chips to see if, one, if they're compatible, two, if I can up the RAM on the machine. Number six, create a game server. If you have a broadband internet connection and you know the machine is fairly decent, you can actually run a game server on older games. For instance, I would recommend Team Fortress 2 or even Minecraft. I myself have used old hardware to run a Team Fortress 2 server of my own. Number seven, scrap and sell. Scrapping and selling. In the past, I've actually scrapped machines for actual metal. For instance, you have an empty case and sheet metal that you can take to a recycling facility and get some cash for it. Now, unless you have a lot, you're really not going to get too much, but there's a lot of different things you can do. For instance, the wires on the power supply. You can snip this, and this is considered low-grade wire. Also, the aluminum heat sinks, depending on how big and how heavy they are, they can actually be worth something as well. Now, something that also coincides with scrapping and selling is actually pulling some of the parts and checking them on eBay to see how much they're actually worth. You can sometimes make some money just selling the actual physical parts from your old machine. For instance, I have this ATI Radeon 8490 that I pulled out of one of my older machines. This is actually worth about 30 bucks, and also there's an older machine that I have that has an E7500 that goes for about $5 to $10. And laptops as well. If for some odd reason the laptop doesn't work, but you know that the screen works and you have the know-how to take it apart, you can sometimes get anywhere between $20 and $40 for the screen itself. People crack their screens all the time. Number eight, donate for a tax deduction. You can also donate a computer or a laptop for a tax deduction. There are plenty of recycling facilities that will actually allow you to donate them for a cause and get an actual tax deduct. For instance, when I was back in Chicago, there was a place called ATEN, the Assistive Technology Education Network, which would actually take the machines, refurbish them, and give them to schools in need. Number nine, make a Steam box. Another great thing you can do is you can use it as a Steam box. You can use it to actually stream your computer games from your main machine to the TV. For instance, I have my main computer in the other room that has a GeForce 960. This computer, in no way, shape, or form, can handle the higher-end games. However, since it has a video card with an HDMI out, I can stream the game to the TV. This especially works great if you have an Xbox 360 controller or any other compatible controller. So it's actually really nice that my computer in the other room is running the game, and I'm able to do this on a bigger screen. I can do it from the couch. And I'm actually still broadcasting live if other people wanted to watch. And I honestly noticed no lag whatsoever between the controller and the computer. They really have this down to a T. So whether you spend $100, or I think it's actually on sale for $50 right now, whether you buy the Steam Stream Box or use this method, it's a really great way to use an old machine. And number 10, LAN machine, test machine, or render box. Last but not least, you can make a LAN machine, test machine, or render box. What I mean by this is you can make a machine just specifically for a LAN party, a test machine in case your machine goes down and you want to test parts, and a render box so if you want a network render for programs such as Blender or 3ds Max. In conclusion, there are lots of things you can do with old computers and old hardware. So before throwing it out, try to think of a way you can use it to improve your life or somebody else's life. And if you absolutely have to get rid of it, please recycle. As always, if you have any questions, comments, or concerns, please feel free to post them below. And if you like this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Have a great one!